Whiteboard Series video. As you can see, Roman, Leo, and Silas are here today, and we're actually going to take a little bit of a different approach. I'm in the new office, got the new backdrop, so we're going to try something new today. Instead of having a term that we're going to cover, we're actually going to have more of a conversation between the three of us, and I want you to hear it, and also want to encourage you to have this conversation with your kids, if you're a parent or your spouse, or even with yourself. If you can see the board in the back, it says wealthy versus rich. And this is a point of emphasis that's been very important to me and on my mind as of late. If you've listened to any of the podcasts, you'll notice and you'll remember that I ask every guest how they define wealth. So I thought it'd be fun today to ask a soon-to-be 8-year-old and a 5.5-year-old what they think wealthy means, soon-to-be 6, sorry, what wealthy means and what rich means. So Roman, I'm going to let you kick the conversation off. And when I ask you, what does it mean to be wealthy? What do you think? What's it mean to be wealthy? To be free. Okay, what do you mean by that? What's it mean to be free?
Like you can do whatever you want.
You can do whatever you want. I think it's a pretty fair definition. Leo, what does it mean to you to be wealthy?
Be healthy.
To be healthy. Okay, so for you, having good health can also be wealthy. If you're wealthy, you're healthy. Or if you're healthy, you're wealthy. Is that right? Is there anything else that you think of when you think about wealthy? No? Okay, well then let's go on the other side. I'll ask you first, Leo. What does it mean to be rich?
A lot of toys
and like a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
So what do you need to have a lot of toys and a lot of stuff?
You need to have a lot of money.
A lot of money. Okay, I'll give you that. So rich is a lot of money, and then wealthy is healthy. Roman, what's it mean to be rich to you?
A lot of money.
A lot of money. Okay, so you both agree a lot of money is rich. So my last question before I get on my soapbox and kind of tell everybody what I think. Leo, if you could be wealthy or rich, what would you be?
Wealthy.
You would be wealthy. Give me 5. I like that answer. Roman, if you could be wealthy or rich, what would you be?
Rich.
You'd be rich. All right. So I'm a little disappointed in that answer, but so I would agree with their definitions of wealthy and rich. If you've listened to the podcast, most of the guests have had similar definitions, and wealthy being not so much about the money, wealthy being having freedom, like Roman said, having flexibility, being able to do the things that you want with the people that you love and the people you want to do those things with. And yes, money helps you get there, but it's very possible to be rich, have a lot of money, but not be happy and not be wealthy. And the same point, you can be wealthy without having a lot of money if you are surrounded by the people that you love and you have enough to meet your needs and enjoy the life that you want to enjoy. So it is a little bit of semantics, you know, wealthy versus rich. You could probably flip-flop them, but I like to think of wealthy being more of a holistic, that's a buzzword in my industry, more of a holistic view on your financial situation. Being wealthy is having the means to not worry. It's having the means to do the things that you want to do and spend the time with the people that you want to spend your time with. And rich is having a lot of things and money. I mean, you know, being rich can help you be wealthy, but also being rich and having a lot of those things doesn't guarantee that you're going to have a meaningful and satisfactory life. So, you know, we try to keep these videos pretty short. So instead of doing a term, today's whole conversation was wealthy versus rich. How do you define it? If you know, talk to your loved ones and kind of have that conversation. I encourage those parents, like I said earlier, have this conversation with your little guys and gals, because it's never too early to start talking to them about money. It doesn't have to be a taboo subject, and the sooner they start to learn about this and begin to develop their values and learn from you as a parent, I think the better off it's going to be. So while Leo made the right choice in choosing wealthy over being rich, and my oldest son leaves me disappointed right now,
I did the real choice.
He did the real choice. He went more for the monetary value over the quality of life approach. So how do you define wealthy and rich? Is it the same? Is it a little bit different? And use those values to help you start with your financial planning and develop where you want to go in your life. So guys, you have anything else to say to everybody?
Nope.
Roman?
Bye-bye.
All right, we'll see you in the next episode.